Upon arrival at the Glauxian Brotherhood retreat, Chard's hopes were dashed to discover what he sought was not to be found there.
Knowledge of these flicks was lost when Perok fell.
But as Chard turned, ready to depart the retreat, the monk took pause, then continued.
There is, however, an elderly hermit named Cormac, who dwells in some old ruins not far from here. He once studied at Perok and might be convinced to help you. But be watchful. A group of monks went to visit him weeks ago, and when they did not return, a few of our younger brethren left to investigate. Neither group has been heard from, and high winds at this time of the year have hampered our search efforts.
Chard pledged to do all he could.
You may have rescued my brethren, but unless the Hag's Fiend Queen is defeated, the abductions will continue, and you can bet their next target will be the retreat itself. We must be especially wary of the Hag's Fiend Queen. She's utterly ferocious and supremely crafty.
No match for me, puny howlet! You can't stop me!
That victory, had I not seen it with my own two eyes. I suppose by now I shouldn't be surprised. Come! Let us help the wounded back to the Brotherhood!
Back at the retreat, there was much to discuss. Bats and hagsfiends working together, with Flex in the midst of it all. The breadth of the Pure One's plans was broad indeed. Just then, the old hermit Cormac approached.
That was a fine bit of flying you did today, Chard. Your father would have been proud.
When the shock had worn off the young owl's face, he continued.
Yes, I was there with him at Perok. Don't believe the lies. He was vigilant and he fought bravely. But the flicks the Hag's Fiends carry can confound any owl's gizzard, as you'll see. We surmised it was an unknown traitor who let the Hag's Fiends in and gave them the flicks. But Grettir never forgave himself. He discarded his battle claws here at this monastery, vowing never to take them up again. I attempted to follow his peaceful example, even opening a dialogue with the Hag's Fiends who dwell in the frigid region. But there is a greater tide of evil at work, and my efforts failed. It would seem the time for your father's idealism has not yet arrived.
Cormac produced a tarnished but magnificent set of battle claws.
Here, these were his. Take them and use them to restore the peace.